Hello friends, here in this video, we will see the types of machine design. When we talk about the types of machine design, we basically have three different kinds of machine design, and they are the different types of machine design are. The first is adaptive design. Next, developed design. Third one, new design. So as we can see, the subject of machine design, it consists of basic three kinds of design. They are adaptive, developed and new. Now let us try to understand each one of them in detail. The description of above are as follows. I'll first start with adaptive design. Adaptive design. Now, see, adaptive design is basically a small modification or minor change in the existing design. It means in case of adaptive, here the component or product is already there, it is existing, and when we make minor changes in that, then we term it as adaptive design. In simple terms, if we can say, adaptive design is not a new design, or we are not designing any product from scratch. Here some product is already there, but we have to just change it or provide some minor modifications. So here I'll write the definition that it is a design in which we make minor modifications in the existing design or product. So if we change slightly some design feature, like for example, if some product is there, if we are just changing its color, then it is called as adaptive design. Or if we are adding some component, we are removing some component, then also it would be called as adaptive design. The next important point in adaptive design is, I'll write it here, that in case of adaptive design, only some basic technical skills are required. So if a person is an adaptive designer, then he should just have some basic technical skills to make any change in the design. Here I can give the examples of adaptive design. The best example which I can give here, it is of diesel engine. Now, as we know, diesel engine is already existing. It is in use. So if we make any small modification in a diesel engine, then it would be termed as adaptive design. So diesel engine comes under the category of adaptive. Next, I can give the example of bicycle. See, bicycle example, why I have given here? Because previously we were having a bicycle which was driven by pedal and there was chain which was transferring the motion. Now if we can see, there are even bicycles which are gear operated. So previously bicycles were existing, then we made small modification in that bicycle by providing gear arrangement, so it became adaptive design. Now we are even having some bicycles which are patented, they operate without the use of the paddle, that is they are battery operated. So as we can see, bicycle was there previously, but now we are giving some small modifications in that, and hence it becomes adaptive design. So these two examples, they are best understood. Then etc. We can have number of examples of existing component, then some small changes are made. So this was regarding the adaptive design. Next is developed design. Now when we talk about developed design, even in this case the existing product is used, but it is used just for the basis. Like in adaptive design, the complete product was there and small changes were made. But in developed design, the existing product would be used just for an idea and a whole new product would be developed. I'll write down. In this case, the existing design or product is just used as a basis, means it would only be used for a reference. Next, entire concept is new and developed to make a product better. So just by taking the idea of the existing product, we are changing the complete object. That becomes a part of developed design. Here I can give the examples. I'll write it onto the next page. The examples of developed design. Now the examples are, first of all, electronic components or equipments. Now see, this is very much understood in today's world that electronic components, if I can take the example of cell phone, we can see number of cell phones which are available with slight modification. That is, previously some design was there, it was used as a reference, and now we are developing on that. Like as we can see, the Apple phones like 6 or 6s, they were developed from some earlier version. That earlier version was acting as a reference, and then we developed a complete new design. So that is a part of developed design. So electronic components or equipments, they are the example of developed design. Next, even tape recorders. Then we can say television sets and like electronic equipments, tape recorders, television sets, and we can even give the example of modified bikes. So here also, as we have seen, these examples, they come under the category of developed design, where we are using the existing model just for the reference and a complete new product is developed. Now at last we will see what is meant by a new design. In new design, the component is developed as a whole, a new product. Here I'll write down. In this design, a component or product is made from scratch, like just starting. And here, as we can see, since we are designing a new component, so the designer must have complete knowledge of designing, because here, since we are designing a new component, the designer should have the complete or thorough knowledge of each component, or we can say factors. So this is one of the most complicated designs. Next, I can give the example of new designs. Examples of new design. Like we can say, solar power plants. See, to set up solar power plants, we require a complete new design of that power plant, and as we are setting up that, so it is called as, it comes under the category of new design. Or we can even say tidal power plants, both of them, solar and tidal, they are used to generate electricity, and when we are setting up them, then it comes under the category of new design. So whatever thing we are making for the first time, that concept, it is called as new design. I can even give the example of 3D printers. That also comes under the category of new design. So as we have seen in this video, we have described the types of machine design basically into three types. They were adaptive design, developed design, and new design. I hope the explanation is understood.